without any more ado, we'll introduce tonight's team, which is high-end potential startups. They've had an idea, they've started it, they're making some money, they're sourcing some serious investment, proper businesses, with a view to kind of sharing and hopefully kind of helping the guys in the room get there a bit quicker, what to do, what not to do, what to avoid. Conor's the founder and CEO of Sproose, which is a convenience service platform. You can find local dry cleaners, laundrettes, and garment care specialists in your area instantly. Your goods will be collected, cleaned, delivered, the provider comes to you. Conor, how did you get started and how did you end up here today?
I was working for an engineering company, like a building power plants, and I kind of realised that most of the things, I was in a team of engineers, and most of the things we were doing were outsourced to experts, you know, and kind of just an epiphany moment when I was there thinking, well, you know, I'm full of ideas, you know, and if I come up with an idea, there's plenty of people who I can probably get in contact with who can, you know, build it for me, or, you know, get at least a prototype up and running to a position where I could get some customers and then get some investors to get some, you know, a full team around me.
Then next we've got Alex. Alex is the founder of Triyit. Triyit, an in-home marketing company that sourced various types of investment, and now they're about to embark on a serious upscaling for the business. What these guys do is help big brands get samples into the hands of their target market.
So I suppose my story is a wee bit different. I had been working as a designer, marketer, in Ayrshire for a really small printers, and kind of felt like I was ready to go for the next level of job. So travelled for a couple of years, ended up in New Zealand, and although I thought that travelling was probably a bad move for my career, I ended up getting the best job of my life. And it just happened that where I ended up in New Zealand, there was a really great solution for young SME companies trying to launch food and drink brands. So I took what I learned from them, from being in America, all the different countries, and against the advice of my wallet and my mum, came back to Scotland. It probably took me 6 months to realise that I had, you know, managed to do enough. We had got the concept, we had validated some of it, but we really needed to go to seek a bit of capital to really get started.
The question we're in the middle of is, how did you go from taking your idea and turning that into business? What's your experience of getting an investment? Because obviously you've got quite a story there. So
prior to Beezer, I actually was part of a group who founded the first crowdfunding platform in Scotland. So what I really quickly learned was it's not what you're, it's who you know in that kind of environment. And once you get one key investor on board that's, you know, had a big hit or a big, sorry, a big win in the past, then it makes it easier to get the other investors on board. It definitely takes a lot longer than you anticipate. I'd say anywhere between 3 and 6 months to raise capital, 3 minimum, 6 months max. There's no standard format for each of the syndicates. So you're not using, you know, one single sort of hymn sheet for each one. Each one wants a different, wants it in their own format, wants the same information dissected from your business plan and put into their format. That in itself can take a month to do. I think if your idea is good enough to get that initial investment in, should be fairly straightforward. It's just a matter of time.